All right, that just happened. Oh shit. I just spit accidentally. Someone accidentally spit. Lister, hi. Hi, welcome to Drive Time. I sometimes like to party, and sometimes partying entails swishing around Listerine in your mouth while you're driving, and then stopping at a stop sign and spitting it out, and then forcing to root through your trash for napkins or some other cleaning device to clean up the spittle that you accidentally spit into the part of the door area. My car is filthy. It's not, you know, usually it's got a box of books in the back right now, but usually there's not a lot of things in it, but it's gross. Like, it hasn't been cleaned. That actually can't hurt the... I feel pretty strongly that didn't make the car any dirtier. If anything, the Listerine cut some grime there. Hi, how are you? Good. Good to hear. Hope you're doing well. This is the B. This is the B on the second half of the lunch stop, and this truck is just zooming on my bum right now. Hey, buddy. Hi. Yeah, you got a nice Ford truck there. Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah. He laid off a little bit. Maybe he knew I was giving him the seductive talk I like to do. That's what I do. Instead of road rage, when I get road rage and when I'm having angry eyes at another fellow driver, I'll just look at him and give him like a kiss. That's nothing new. That's actually kind of that's not cool. I don't really do that anyway. Yeah, it's Friday, the March 8th. You can see from with your eyes, there's snow. On the trees and on the ground, and it's warming though, so it's melting pretty fast. I think I'm gonna run outside in this, because I think the precip should be tapering, but I don't know if I wanna, because I gotta fuck with my my camera fast test that I was talking about. If you're a long-time listener and watcher of the program, you know about my camera vest. Important stuff here. Important stuff. Friday, you know, when I get to this part of the week, and this is kind of my downfall in a lot of ways. I'm always itching for a cocktail hour. When can I have that nice martini? Dirty martini, man. You know why? Because it's you don't fuck around with that. It's just a non-fuck around drink. It's just the saltiness of the olives, the olive juice. I think it's delightful taste. It's an acquired taste, and one I haven't always liked. But it's great, and it's just you're not fooling around. You're not fooling anybody with that drink. It's the dirty martini. Gin. Some Margo vodka. Not the worst one ever in Washington D.C. Oh. Did not know how to. It's always a bad sign when they say vodka or gin. The vodka martini. I don't know if people make dirty martinis with the vodka. If you ask for a dirty martini, aren't you? That's gin, right? So make a vodka dirty martini. Like, I think of when people think of when vodka martinis, they're talking about like drinks in martini glasses that involve vodka that aren't martinis. And this has been Booze Time with your host Vernon Howe. So that's where my mind's headed. I got them halfway done. I'm still only halfway done with the weekly pitchfork scoring that I've been doing. And for like whole 6 days, so since last Friday, I let this slide, and I'm doing it all today. And I can see the finish line. It's very tedious, thankless work. Why would it be thank? You know what? I don't know who I want to thank me for it. I don't know why. It's one of these. I don't know yet. I hope to be enlightened one day. Yeah, I'm on day 45. So after this weekend, it'll be 48 days. I've cataloged every review. So 48 times 5. And what is it? Like almost two, little shade under 250 by a few. 240 or something like that. Reviews that I've gone through. So it's a lot of shit. And it's a lot of data. And it's a lot of crap. And it's a lot of time. It's a lot of my time. And, you know, I hope that there's a point to it all. And I hope, like, at least one other person gets something out of it or is entertained by it. You know, I do it on Tumblr, on a Tumblr blog. I don't have a lot of time, but it's funny that every once in a while one of those posts will get reblogged. And I'm always just like, what? Why one of these posts would get reblogged? Because it's such a serial and... I mean, I do make singular points in each blurb I write, but I don't know. I don't understand the world. That's what I'm trying to say. Got a half tank of gas. Got halfway done with the work day on this Friday, and then it's the weekend. And maybe, just maybe, there'll be a special weekend edition of this program. Stay tuned.